There we
Bryce,
go.
what are you wearing? Is that a spoon?
Yeah.
Hi,
Welcome to Emotional Labor. This is the show where we do the discourse so you don't have to. I'm joined today by Magneto and April, otherwise known as the most famous trans comedy duo of all time, Girl God. Thank you very much for being on the show.
thank you
Thank
for
you for
having
having
us.
us. Sorry, I'm just coming from the shoot.
The shoot?
Right, is this the Marvel one?
Yeah,
We'll be announcing it by the time this interview airs, but I'm Magneto in the new movie, Grace,
and
that's yeah, it's pretty, amazing. Oh my God. it's pretty cool. They're making Congrats. Magneto transsexual instead of Jewish in this one. I mean, why So not both, really? It's 2024.
yeah, that's what I said too, and Kevin Feige yelled at me a lot.
Yeah, He well, he's screamed like a
at me.
bigot, right?
He threw stuff at me. No, he didn't do it in a bigoted way. He's
Oh,
just
okay, just in a violent way.
passionate about the comics. He's passionate about the comics. And
What's
I
Magneto's
respect
thing? He
that.
like Magneto was like in the Holocaust or something? He Or his
so
family?
in the comics, he survived the Holocaust.
Okay.
But they're kind of turning it on its head in
Are they
movies.
keeping the
So
Holocaust thing even though they're making
they're
you
keeping
trans?
his involvement in the Holocaust. He's kind of on the other side of things. He's kind of a transsexual Nazi.
Okay.
So I'm actually playing a trans man. I don't think Kevin
There's
understood.
historical precedent for that, right?
Oh,
Is
really?
there could be a biopic about this guy? There's an Oscar with your name in it, Grace.
Yeah, we got to get the rights to that. We're doing a lot of natural effects, so I've got this stuck to my knows from pretty much the duration of filming.
I respect the commitment. How many hours in the makeup chair is that?
But the like 12 a day. And you know what's crazy though? This helmet, this is CGI.
You're kidding.
This is all CGI.
Are you telling me you're not in a black and white haunted lair as well?
No, this is, yeah, I'm on set right now. This
Okay,
is
I
all,
thought so.
yeah.
Yeah.
The helmet is CGI.
Thank you so much for that exclusive right there, Grace. I wanted to ask you both, did you ever get any flack for saying 1-844
1-844
Dilator
Dilator.
and WGN News? Did anyone ever like call you up on that? Do they
We
know that? Do they get actually did not the
get any
no?
flack.
Do you
No,
think they
that
just
was
didn't clock it? they did
It's
not get
crazier
it at
than
all.
that, I think, actually, because they asked us like before the segment. It's like, is this a joke or a real hotline people can call? So we didn't lie to them exactly. But what really is crazy is the hotline was live. They could have called and seen exactly what it was, but they didn't do it. So.
They took our word for it. And then, yeah, at no point, when we were telling them about it on the air, at no point did eyebrows go up or anything.
One of them near the end, I think, understood.
Okay.
One
But it
of
was
them,
like
like
they're.
very near the end, was like eyes went big, but the other one didn't.
There
The other
was.
did not at
But
any point.
they just kept saying, like, you guys are doing such important work.
When
Like,
we so after our
allies.
segment, there came up to us and was like, thank you so much for doing what you do. It's so important. And please stay here with us. We care about you.
Please
Stay
stay here with
here.
us. Just being on suicide risk all the time. Yeah.
Honestly, not too far from truth for me.
I mean, that's because you're living with your memories of guilt from the Holocaust.
Yeah, I'm really
Yeah.
embodying the character. It's really hard to play someone who killed millions of people. Because in Marvel's version of the Holocaust, Magneto used his metal powers to do all the bad stuff.
Okay.
I think the boy in the striped pajamas, instead of them in a gas chamber, they just got pierced with a bunch of forks.
Okay.
On
That's a
that note,
wonderful picture. How good are the Dave Chappelle residuals? Real good.
April, you want to take this
Yeah,
one?
they're real good. I don't work anymore. Grace does the acting thing just because it's kind of like a hobby for her, you Sure. know? She doesn't even need the paychecks, but the residuals are great. Writing for one of the biggest comedians of all time is one of the last ways in the industry to make money still. These days,
That one,
it's hard. Unless you get a gig like this.
when we started back in the day, you know, there were a few jobs trans women could get, okay? Sex work, food service, and writing jokes for Dave Chappelle.
This is in the
And
90s, right?
thank God that we got to write jokes for Dave Chappelle
Yes.
in the 90s,
Yeah.
you know?
Exactly. Exactly. Yeah.
Grace, what will it take for you to learn the rules of chess?
I would say that I know as much as I need at any given moment. I will learn the rules of chess exactly when I need to, and not a moment too soon.
That's cryptic and sinister. April, did you actually meet Bill Gates? And why didn't you kill him when you had the chance?
I didn't kill him because I was at work. If I weren't at work, I would have done. If there's any possible employers listening to this, not that I need to work anymore because of the residual situation, but if there's any possible employers listening to this, you should know I'm not going to kill anyone on the clock, okay? I will keep business and my personal conflicts with the world's billionaires separate.
One job
Don't
at
worry.
a That's a better explanation than mine, because when I met Bill Gates once, the reason why I didn't kill him was, sometimes you just need cock.
And he's going to supply it. Am I right or am I right?
He's got 5 inches of iron down there. Listen, a rock hard 5 inches is better than a floppy seven.
He knows how to use it.
That's true. You don't become the CEO of a billion-dollar company without knowing how to use your 5 inches.
Grace, you've written for online platforms like The Onion, Funny or Die, and you've also worked in TV with shows like Rick and Morty and The Eric Andre Show. Now, with some of those shows, they involve people who have been involved in a lot of controversy. And I wanted to ask you, do you support profiteering off of NFTs like Eric Andre does?
I do not sell NFTs, and I don't think that they're good, but I also think that they're bad. I think it's not good to do that. And sometimes your friends do stuff that you don't agree with.
Okay, is this in character as Nazi Magneto or is this Grace?
Oh, I just think, as personally, I would not sell NFTs.
Personally, I will.
Chase the bag.
Yeah, Girl God's personal crypto. That's right. Well, you might be thinking, is this the right time to launch your own cryptocurrency? Yes, you can buy Grace Coin on our website.
Wait,
You
we're
can buy
calling it
it's
Grace Coin and not Girl God Coin?
yes, I can. We I can see.
Or
I can
Girl
see.
Gold, Girl God's Girl Gold.
No,
That's pretty smart.
we're calling it
Wow.
Grace Coin.
Okay.
You can buy
You're the
Grace
safe
Coin on
place.
our website. Currently, no major companies accept Grace Coin, but we're hoping that that will change by 2030.
It's just a matter of time. April, as a former women's studies doctorate candidate, which group of women deserves to be scrutinized the most?
I would say the hot ones. It's just nice. They're just nice to look at, right? The ugly ones, you're not going to want to look at as much. They're not as visually pleasing to the eye. So don't bother with those. I would say stick to the hot ones.
Fit birds only, no manners. Grace, why are you listed as the secondary guest on your podcast with April?
Oh, I'm dumber. April's smarter, and I'm dumber.
No, I didn't say
And
that.
there was a long legal battle. There was
Okay.
a
To
long
prove that
legal
you're not
battle.
permanent, that April was smarter and thus should be the main one.
And look, no hard feelings, Kay. Lots of accusations were thrown around. Okay, documents were forged, but that's all water under the bridge.
April's so good at forging documents, and I'm so bad at it, which is just more proof that April should be number one.
April, I found a poem that you wrote at university, and I'm going to read
Oh,
a section of it.
absolutely not. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, my God.
So,
Oh, no.
I
No,
want.
no, no, no. Oh, God. Oh, no, please, no. I'm begging you. I'm begging you. Please, please, please keep that to yourself. Please
It's
treasure
publicly
it.
online. It's like the sixth result for your name.
Ah, really?
Yeah.
No, that can't be true.
I'm not lying
I
to you.
have to get that taken down somehow. Oh God. Oh no, that's terrible. Oh geez. Oh man. Okay.
But a specific stanza in question is, I want to
Oh.
know that there's a girl whose mother loves her. If you love me, then you
No,
love her more than I do.
no, no. Oh, I
I'm
can't
picked
even
out for
hear
myself.
that. Oh God. Oh God.
On that note, the follow-up question is fuck, marry, kill.
I feel like I've been stabbed.
Marge Simpson, Lois Griffin, and the wife from Bob's Burgers.
Yeah.
Oh, geez. I think fuck Lois. Yeah, fuck Lois. Marry Linda. Yeah, kill Marge. What do you think, Errol? Have you recovered?
No, I haven't recovered. It's okay. Oh, God. I would say Marge.
Lois, and Linda from Bob's.
Fuck Marge, marry Linda, and kill Lois.
Wow.
Sorry.
Wow.
Yeah. Sorry if that's controversial.
No, I mean, it makes a lot of sense to me.
You can kind of see the logic there.
It's obviously marry Linda. Are you going to kill Lois or kill Marge? I think Marge kind of hates her existence. So I think you would be trying to kill her.
Grace, on the Downside podcast, you said Hoku's got bitches. That's a TV show. Who do you like more, black people or Asian people?
This is a series of really good gotcha questions.
What did I say?
Hoku's got bitches.
I said, who do I like better? I would say that I think that, to me, I am legally not allowed to answer that question because April is my legal guardian. So she kind of has to decide that for me.
Okay, April, as Grace's legal guardian, can you answer that question for her?
Yeah, black people or Asian people? Well, after going through Grace's search history, etc., and keeping close tabs on everything she says, I'd say it's actually very difficult. And I'm not totally sure if Grace fully understands the difference.
Yeah.
So it's complicated, you know. What you have to understand about Grace is that she doesn't really operate like most people.
She doesn't
see how. I think to start, you'd have to. Maybe if you could explain to Grace the difference between black people and Asian people.
Specifically, like go into depth.
That would help.
And okay, definitely don't be facile about it. I want you to define specifically different qualities.
Okay, I'm going to pull up like a phenotype list. I'm going to get into the real eugenics of it. It's going to get really weird.
Great. And this is back to Grace now.
Oh, it's back to me.
Can you tell me anything about a movie? I hear you guys are working on one. Don't worry, no one's going to see this, so you can just say whatever.
We are currently writing something. We can't say like what the thing is, but it is kind of like a mockumentary, but also like about the making of it. And I'm excited about it.
And that's a real answer, actually. And
that is a real answer about a thing.
Yeah, and another real answer is that we're actually working on a follow-up to, everyone's heard of it, Crash 2004. This time it's about reverse racism.
Mm-hmm.
So we think that should be interesting.
We think that's going to be our Oscar.
Yeah. Definitely. The first Crash, you know, massive success at the time. Historically, it's looked down upon.
Was
we
it
think,
about
let's even the score. Let's make a reverse racism Crash. That's the Cronenberg
Crash. That one isn't about racism at all.
Okay, this is like a race angle.
Yeah, there's a movie from 2004.
That won a bunch of Oscars and stuff.
It might have been Best Picture. I don't remember. Or it was nominated. I don't know. But
I think it did win Best Picture.
One of the kind of like, I don't want to say original, but an early like woke Oscar bait film, I would say. So
it was kind of like the Green Book of its time.
Okay.
Yeah.
And we're going to do it again, baby.
Run it back. Amazing. Thank you both so much for your emotional labor. I really appreciate it. Is there anything that you'd like to ask me?
Yeah.
Any question?
We should rake all the races. All of them. Starting now.
I should name all the races. Or I should rank all the races.
Rank.
Oh, rank them. Okay.
No, you don't have to do it right now, but think about it and get back to me.
No, I've got it. I've got my rank here. You're kidding me. It's easy. It's people of color and white people.
Pretty good. That's a pretty good easy response.
That's nice. You should be paying your PR person extra because that's good. Good work.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for having us on.
Thank you for having us. This was a blast.
That's okay. Emotional labor. Thank you so much. Bye.
again. HTML.
First off, get off my dick, it's not your sister.